from Freedom Church coming at you live from my house here. And welcome all students from the school. Welcome all students from the church. Any parents and anybody else who may be viewing, everybody's welcome. I have a 10-second counter here on deck, and which will give you the, I'm about to start it in a minute here, but that will give you an opportunity to get a snack, a beverage, and maybe do a bathroom run. So what I want that to do is make sure that you, hey, you've got everything you need and that you can focus in on God, okay? So here we go. Hopefully too that will that you got everything first of all, and then I'll also get out some wiggles, okay? Maybe some inhibitions too, because you know we can worship God. It should be a natural thing, as a matter of fact, and you know, but just get us moving, get us loose. All right, so we're gonna jump on into, matter of fact, is our first worship song, okay? So give it all you got. Give it all to God, okay? Here, he's listening and he's watching. Alrighty, that was a really good worship song. I love it. I love it, love it, love it, love it, love it. And I hope you did too. But we're gonna move on. We got things to do, things to learn, okay? So here we go. Oh, man, I keep forgetting this. I keep forgetting it, and I hope you don't forget it as much as I do. But hey, I'm here to remind you specifically. I'm gonna ask you, what is the name of this program? And everybody said, okay, okay, okay. You know, I think I got a little bit more roar in me. How about you? Let's try it again. All right, here we go. On a count of three. One, two, three. All right, all right, all right. We got a holy roar out to God this morning, and hopefully your whole neighborhood heard, because I know mine did, all right? So anyhow, move them right along. I'm going to ask you to bow your heads and close your eyes there at home, parents included, okay? So we're going to say this together. All right, we're going to say it out loud because we got a right relationship with God, okay? I'm just saying. So we can talk to him just like we talk to our moms, our dads, and other people that we know, right? So let's do this. All right, so Heavenly Father, I know you. I know you as Father. And anyways, moving right on. Through Jesus Christ, your son, I know him too. Anyway. And by the Holy Spirit, we know him too. And he lives in us. Okay. But we come to you in prayer, okay? Lord, we ask that you would help us to have healing and cleansing faith. Okay, that comes from God. He gives it to us, okay? So help us to have that, okay? Help us to know your deep love for us, okay? Because it is. It's so deep. It's so deep. It's deeper than any sea, okay? Which he created, by the way. Anyways, but moving on. Open our hearts and our minds to learn your word and what the Bible says about Jesus heals the woman who believed. She just believed. Praise God. God helped her believe, and she believed. All right? So he gave her that heart and mind and everything she needed to believe. Okay, so moving on. Lord, teach us what you want us to know about Jesus. And everybody there at home said, and everybody here said, amen. Okay, you're at home, and I just realized I'm at home too. Praise God. Hallelujah. Anyhow, I'm moving right along. So our topic for today is Jesus heals the woman who believed, okay? And it is coming from the series Knowing Jesus, 31 lessons, okay, baby? And we is just moving right along. We're just moving. All right, so today's lesson is the 15th. I'll do it like that. You do it like that too at home. 15th of the series Knowing Jesus through the book of Mark. So we're almost halfway done, okay, through the series. Anyway, this lesson, it focuses on when Jesus heals a woman and commends her for having great faith, okay? So I can't even swallow. Anyway, in today's Bible verses, which were written by Mark back when, way back when, Jesus was here on earth. And we read about how Jesus has great compassion and love for those who suffer. Okay? Great compassion and love for those who suffer. That's what Jesus has. Okay? Jesus also shows great love and grace in healing and cleansing a woman who has faith in him. Okay? Jesus is the only one who has the power to cleanse us from disease and sin, okay? Disease and sin. He has the power to cleanse us, and he's the only one that does, okay? So moving right along, just checking to see if I ain't blocking your words and stuff, but anyhow. So on the count of three, tell me who loves you. And, okay, yes, it can be more than one person, okay? So here we go. One, two, three. Who loves you, baby? All right. Okay. That's a whole lot of love. That's a whole lot of love. And for participation and good behavior so far, okay? You know, because it could go wrong. It could go all wrong. But anyway, for participation and good behavior so far, God is great. And it is green, like the grass and everything outside is so beautiful and vibrant. Anyways. Okay, so that's a lot of love, right? Whole lot of love. People got love for you. Okay, now think of why they love you. Why don't these people love you? Okay, you got mad peeps in your life. Why did they all love you? Most of the people in our lives love us just cause. They just cause, okay? Just because. Their love is what they call unconditional. All right, say that with me. Unconditional, okay? Unconditional, which means, I know it's a big word, let's break it down. It means they love us no matter what. No matter what we do, say, act, whatever, okay? They love us, okay? They love us for who we are to them. We might be their child, okay? We might be their student, their friend, their mother, the brother, the sister, the cousin. Oh my goodness. You know, they love us for who we are to them. And God loves each of us deeply, okay? It's serious. It's a serious love, okay? He loves you. Point to yourself, okay? Point to myself. You point to yourself, okay? God, and say this with me. God loves me, okay? And mean it. Just say it to yourself again. God loves me, okay? All right, moving on. God, he knows every detail about each one of us, okay? Isn't that amazing? Like every single detail. From our biggest fear, you know, to how many hairs on our heads, okay? He knows all these little details about us. Everything, 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 everything. Say that with me. Everything. Okay. All right. I'm thinking of some girls, two little girls I know from church who got some soul, and they would have said it just like me, okay? Anyhow, but moving on. In today's lesson, we will hear how Jesus showed his great love for a certain woman. So listen up, so together we can get to know more about Jesus, okay? The Bible says in Mark 5:21-34, that Jesus had been teaching, okay? And Jesus had been spreading the good news, all right? He had been doing that. And Jesus has also had been healing the sick. Whoa, you know, boom, I'm healthy again, okay? And Jesus had calmed a storm. These are things we've been reading about. And some people, they are afraid of Jesus, you know, and they do not want him around, okay? They just trying to get out, you know, that's how they be doing him, okay? They think, matter of fact, that Jesus is a liar, okay? Liar. That's how they be thinking. But then there's some other people, and these is my peoples right here, I know they is, make me think of heaven and even youth camp and stuff like that. But these is my peoples right here. They are very interested in what Jesus has to say, okay? And these people is also wanting and willing to follow Jesus everywhere, okay? I'm talking about everywhere. Say that with me. Just to be all loose with it and say everywhere, okay? All right, so we're going to move on. The Bible goes on to say that Jesus has just left a town, you know, way back there, where they did not want him, okay? You ever been like, ever felt like that? You just left. Some they didn't want you there, so you just left, okay? They don't want him around anymore because they were afraid of him, okay? They were afraid of him. Jesus got in his boat. All right, he just jumped right up in that boat, all right? And he traveled to the other side of the lake. And I don't know if he was paddling or maybe some of his disciples was paddling, okay? But let's do that, okay? I'm already been doing it because I love to paddle. I kayak and stuff and stuff. But, and I want to go and I want to get to the other side of the lake too. And I want to, you know, get this lesson in too. So let's get in our boat and travel with him to the other side. I like to go fast too, so let's kick it. All right, we rode that boat all the way over. All right, so after crossing the lake, we're a little tired, okay, but shake it off, baby, okay? A large group of people crowded around Jesus. They got in real close, you know, elbow to elbow, shoulder to shoulder. And we as part of that crowd, okay, because we're doing the same thing today. We're just pressing in and closing in, getting closer and closer to Jesus and hearing more and more about him, okay? They wanted to hear him teach. I do too. I love when he teaches me something new. Oh, he does it all the time, so many different ways. Anyways, he's the greatest teacher in the whole world. But moving right along, we want to see if he is going to perform miracles, okay? And we want to see if he is going to perform miracles. Suddenly, we see a man come up to Jesus real close, you know. He looks a little worried, a little worried, you know. Okay, you know, and he falls down at Jesus' feet, okay? And he begs Jesus, calm him, my daughter who is dying. That's what he does, you know, it's just, you know, boom. And Jesus begins to follow him to his home, okay? He begins to do that. And we're going to follow too. So let's follow, okay? Let's just follow Jesus and this man to his home, okay? We start doing that. In fact, the whole crowd starts following Jesus. And there's so many people that were bumping into one another. Oh my goodness, we're bumping into each other all over the place. And there in the midst of all this, okay, there's a woman, one woman in the crowd. And she's been bleeding for 12 years, okay? 12 years, that's a long, long time. From where on her body? The Bible don't tell us, so we don't know. She has seen many, many, many doctors, okay? One after the other, boom. And she has spent all of her money, okay, to find a cure, but nothing, I'm telling you, nothing works. I don't even know what I did. I done messed this up. Okay. Boom, we're back on the same page. Nothing has worked. No doctor could help her. She is getting worse and worse and worse and worse, okay? Then she heard about Jesus, all right? And she thought to herself, if I could just touch his robe, I can be healed, okay? So she squeezes through all the people, which was hard. I can just imagine how hard that was. So many people crowded around Jesus. And she gets real close to Jesus and then touches his robe, okay? What do you think is going to happen next? What do you think is going to happen next? Okay? Think about that for a minute. Anybody? Let's check it out. Let's move on. Immediately, her bleeding stopped. Okay? She felt in her body that she had been healed. And baby, I know that feeling. And it makes you just want to dance for him. Oh, anyways, but moving on. Jesus knew right away that power had gone from him into someone else. Okay, I'm not Jesus, but you know, him into someone else. He turned around to the crowd and said, "Who touched my robe?" The disciples thought, that's a weird question. That's such a weird question that he would be asking. Why would he be asking this question? Because there were so many people crowded around him that many have probably touched him. And he's asking this question? That's weird. That's so weird. That's what the disciples thought anyways. The woman shook. She shook in fear as Jesus looked out at the crowd. Okay, he's looking out and he's looking. But she fell down before him. And I don't know if you can see me, but she fell down before him and told him the whole truth and nothing but the truth. She just poured it out, okay? She was just honest with him and poured it all out. Jesus responded and told her something very important. Catch this, baby. Babies at home, catch this, okay? He said, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your disease." Ooh, let me say that again. Jesus responded and told her something very important. He said, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go and be healed of your disease." Okay? Before moving on, let's talk about this story, okay? Because I really do want to move on and get her done and everything, you know, so that you guys can view it at home. But let's talk about this story a minute, okay? What do you think about this woman? Anybody? Well, I'm going to tell you what I know about this woman, what I've read so far. This woman from the Bible, this woman, she had been sick for 12 years. That's a long time. She did not know what was wrong with her. No human did, as a matter of fact. And no human had been able to heal her either. She heard about Jesus. She experienced hope, okay? All right, and I just want to stop and say, children, all kiddos, you are the hope for the future of this generation. But moving right along. She truly believed that if she could just touch the back of Jesus' robe, she could be healed. Okay? She had never met Jesus, and yet she believed, you know? The truth had drawn her to him, all right? It just draws you to him. God himself gave her a heart that had faith and believed in who he was. Do you think it was touching Jesus' robe that healed her? Or was it her faith? I think it was her faith. Bible says it was her faith. Okay, now we talked about this woman. What do you think about Jesus in this story? Do you think Jesus really did not know who touched him? This is Jesus we're talking about, okay? Jesus is God, all right? I think he knows everything, all right? He knows every single thing, okay? Jesus already knew who the woman was, all right? Jesus knew she had touched him. Jesus knew she had been sick for 12 years. Like I said, he knew everything. And he still does. And he always will. Why do you think he asked all the people, who touched me? Okay, why do you think he did that? Jesus wanted the crowd to see who he was and what he desires from them, okay? Jesus was teaching us and showing something about himself. Jesus loves each of us. Just point to yourself, as I'm gonna point to myself, okay? Jesus loves each of us deeply. Jesus loved this woman and desired to speak to her face to face, okay? That in-person kind of thing right there. This woman never forgot the day Jesus spoke to her, man, because, I mean, it would just been amazing, just off the chain, you know. I don't even have words to describe how wonderful and magnificent and fabuloso it would be to just have a conversation with Jesus face to face. Such a lucky and blessed woman. Not lucky, but blessed, okay, and highly favored, okay? Blessed and highly favored this woman was. Okay, this woman never forgot that day Jesus spoke to her. Jesus called her daughter and probably looked her right in the eyes. I mean, eyeball to eyeball, boom. You know, imagine that. Wow. Each of us are God's children. We are his daughters and his sons. God loves each of us as his children. God desires for us to have faith. God desires for us to believe in who he is. If we know Jesus, I mean truly know him, got a relationship with him, walk and talk with him, you know, and just chill with him and hang out with him, then we will recognize his voice, okay? That's my Jesus, okay? We can hear his voice in his word, which is the Bible, okay, boom. You should have one at home. All right, we'll recognize his voice in his word. We can hear his voice when we are doing something sinful. Ooh, something bad, something that we know that he would not approve of. And that may even harm us or harm others, okay? We can hear his voice when we are afraid, you know? When I'm afraid, I can hear his voice. You know, speaking to me and speaking peace and calm and good things and pure things and holy things, you know, just speaking to me, comforting things to me. We can believe it is his voice that comforts and guides us because we are his children, okay? We belong to him and he belongs to us. All right, boom. In closing, shut that door, bam, okay? What is impossible with humans is possible with God, okay? All things are possible. No human could heal this woman, boom. But Jesus could because he alone is God. And like this woman, we are sick. Our sickness is called sin. We sin every day and or every time, I'm sorry. We sin every time we disobey God. That might be every day. I'm not sure. But probably it is. Anyways, our hearts are very sick and dirty with sin from the time we were born. Okay? Jesus can cleanse us and make us pure, whiter than snow, and pure from our sin when nothing else can. No matter how many good things we do, and we can do millions and gazillions and have less and less of good things that we get or done, you know, our hearts can never be cleansed from sin, okay? We can try all kinds of different things to do that, and boom, it's just not going to happen. But Jesus can cleanse us, just like he cleansed this woman from her sickness. Jesus died on the cross for us so that we could be made clean. Having finished the lesson, let's focus in on God and the words to the following song. Let's worship him for who he is and all he has done as we sing and dance, expressing our love to him. Okay, basically, we're just going to shake off any inhibitions and just press into the presence of God, okay? Because that's where we find everything we need. We find him, okay? So here we go.
Set. God tonight. Listening to me on this record, I don't know what it is you're going through, but God said you can get your breakthrough tonight. Look at somebody, say, I'm going to get my breakthrough tonight. Right now. Turn around behind you and say, I'm going to get an instantaneous breakthrough. Now, you've been praying and seeking God and fasting, but when you ask God, do you really have faith that he can do it? Do you serve a God that is able? Do you serve a God that is strong and mighty? Well, if you do, can I tell you how to get your breakthrough? Say, Kirko, how can I get my breakthrough right now? You don't know what I'm going through. You don't know what I've been through. This is how you can get it tonight.
Basically, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you are missing out on the opportunity of a lifetime to have a relationship with God, the Father, okay? And you're just, I don't want you to miss it today. This is the opportunity coming to your front door, all right, to get right with God and to have that relationship and have him with you always, okay? And just to know everything about him that you want to ever know, okay, and can know as humans. It starts with a simple prayer, and so we're going to say that together, you at home with me, okay? Let's just do this. Dear God, I know I'm a sinner, and I ask for your forgiveness. I believe Jesus Christ is the Son of God. I believe that Jesus died for my sin. I believe that you raised Jesus to life. I want to trust Jesus as my Savior. I want to follow Jesus as Lord from this day forward. Lord, guide my life and help me to do your will. I pray all of this in the name of Jesus. And everybody there at home said amen. And I'm saying amen. And if you've said that for the first time and you sincerely believe that, then you have been saved by the power of God and the Holy Spirit going along with it. His word and his by his son and everything he did on the cross, you are saved. You are a new creation. You are newborn, okay? And with that comes responsibility, and that means building on that relationship, that foundation, just building on it and learning more about God and how he loves you and how you could love him and others, okay? And so my advice and recommendation is, if you want to continue to grow in this relationship that you've just established, then read your word, okay, and pray. There's prayers in the Bible that if you don't know how to pray, you can learn how to pray, okay? And then also be with God's people, whether it's online or it's in person, drive-in, whatever, however you can do it, be with God's people, okay? And celebrate as we all learn together and we get to worship him and just be with each other, okay? Those are my recommendations. You can also listen to praise and worship music to help bring in good things, you know, about God, and just meditate on him and who he is in your life, okay? And then that'll help you express your love to him. freely and naturally, okay? So those are my recommendations. But for right now, I know the heavens are celebrating, and I am too in my spirit. And so we're going to just keep moving forward because this is a journey we're on, and we just can't stop and stand still. We got to keep going, okay? So our memory verse is memorizing God's word in a way that we is one way we can follow Jesus. Memorizing God's word, let me start over, is one way that we can follow Jesus. Doing motions to the words in today's memory verse helps us remember them. Okay, so let's learn God's word now together. Mark 5:34 said, Jesus, he said to her, okay? I'm pointing to you and outward, but point yourself. So he's talking to me, okay? And you could put son in there if you're a boy, okay? But he said to him or her, okay? Jesus said to, I'm going to say her because I'm a her, okay? Jesus said to her, daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your disease, okay? So Jesus, let's do that together, okay? That started a little quick on you. Jesus said to her, point to this, she's talking to me, daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of your disease. And I think I missed some of the emotions there. I know I had a bunch of them, but I'm gonna move right along. I did forget today, but I know I did have motions for these, but we're gonna move on. Maybe you can make some up and video yourself and send them to me, okay? That would be great. Maybe I'll post them up on our Facebook page or something, or our YouTube. So our challenge today, the one that I want to go into some detail about, because it's important, okay? Listening for God's voice challenge, okay? All right, we're going to listen for God's voice. In order to do this, I'm asking you, giving you this this mission, pretty much, I'm challenging you to spend some time either in prayer, reading your word, or playing music, worship music. So doing that, but I want you to stop when you're doing that and just listen. Just pause for a few and listen to what God is saying to you, okay? Because he's talking to you through those things, okay, while you're doing those things, okay? And he talks to us throughout the day, no matter what we're doing, especially if we're doing something to help build his kingdom in some fashion or form. He's always talking to us, okay? I also want you to just experience and enjoy hearing from God, okay? Because it is an experience, and it does bring joy when you hear from God, okay? So practice hearing from God regularly. I highly recommend it, and I believe it will help you grow in your faith and in your love for God. So do that challenge, okay? Jesus heals the woman who believed. There's a coloring page up on our Facebook page, Roar Children's Ministries Facebook page, okay? And my YouTube channel is Angela Bostwick, okay? Because I didn't explain that. But color that up, show and tell that to others, and spread some good news about Jesus, okay? Testimonies, prayer requests, and needs. Matter of fact, if you have young kiddos, if you have a testimony, a personal testimony, something God did for you personally, your family even, record yourself doing that. I will put that on our Facebook page, boom, like that, okay? Prayer requests, if you have prayer requests, get them to me and we will join you in prayer and take those to the throne room of God. All right, any needs, I will direct them accordingly through our church body, and we will do our best to get her done. If not, we'll take him again to the throne room where he has the riches of heaven to rain down on us, all of us, okay? So, bow your heads, close your eyes, because we're going to close in prayer. Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, and by the Holy Spirit, we come to you in prayer. Thank you, Lord, for helping us to have healing and cleansing faith, and for helping us to know your deep love for us. Thank you for opening our hearts and our minds to learn your word and what the Bible says about Jesus heals the woman who believed. Thank you for teaching us what you want us to know about Jesus. And everybody there at home said, and me too, amen. Good job, good job. Till next time, know that I love and miss you. I love you, okay? And I hope to see you soon. We have service this Sunday. Oh, you need to come on and join us, all right? Come. Come and join us, all right? Stay healthy, safe, and strong. Also, remember to read, pray, worship, and serve, all right? You did a remarkable job learning about Jesus today, okay? Virtual stamps, green, which is God is great again. For everybody, for good behavior and participation. So, here's a little something guaranteed to rock your sock off, okay? That hopefully will help keep you on fire for Jesus. Here we go.
Free.